purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb, always reminding me that we're apart. You wander down the lane and far away, leaving me a song that will not die. Love is now the stardust of yesterday, the music of the years gone by.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm back here at these structures that I found a few days back. I don't really notice too many differences. I noticed a few different glyphs and a few subtle little things, but I haven't noticed any construction or whatever new. But actually, I came back today to talk about my experience I had, well, I guess it's not quite a week ago now. Some days back, anyway. And it was kind of like the Love Zap, too. Now, just revisiting the Love Zap very, very briefly. It was when I got zapped with that loving universal energy for the first time, and I realized that we were all one and all connected. There was a huge download of information with it. But basically, I had that universal knowing of all one and all connected. Not only did I have the knowing, I felt the love and the connection, which is something amazing to feel. Something that I hope, you know, all of you can experience too, because it really is life-changing. But in any event, so a few days back, I was lying in bed, just got into bed, and all of a sudden I just felt like there was, hard to explain, you know, some of these things, like when you haven't experienced them exactly like they happened before, it's kind of hard to explain, but it kind of felt like I was zooming off someplace, or I was, something was opening up, or something was, yeah, it's really hard to explain, unfolding, whatever. But what it felt like, and it was actually a physical feeling, I could see it in my mind's eye, and I could feel it. And what happened was, is that my heart expanded. I could feel it coming right out of my chest and expanding, and it went wide, 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 everywhere. And it was part of the entire universe. My heart was connected in to the universe. And I remember having that same connected feeling as I have with the Love Zap of connection and all one. Now, it was funny because that very day, I was getting caught up in, you know, with all the things that are going on in the world today. I know better. I mean, in order to raise your vibe, you kind of have to rise above that stuff. I mean, it's a fine line. It's, but it's kind of hard to ignore. But I mean, really, the best thing that we can do is just keep our vibe high and send love out and whatever, and that's the best way to combat that. But, you know, it's still with the lunacy of the world, it's still at times it brings you down or whatever. And so, on that particular day, I had found myself arguing with a few people over the Black Lives Matter issue and just, you know, if everything that's happening today is just naturally occurring or if there's some design behind it, that kind of thing. And so I actually lost two friends off Facebook that day. One person dumped me because they didn't agree with what I was saying. And the other person actually was quite rude to me and against my nature, but, well, I shouldn't say that, I've done it before, but it's not the proper way to behave. But anyway, I dumped them as a friend, just because I just thought the gap was just too wide, I didn't see any point, although, you know, in theory, we should be able to connect and coexist with not talking about that and not judging. But in any event, so here I am with my heart connected into the entire universe and I'm there. And because those two people were part of the whole, I felt the loss. I felt the loss of them. Like they weren't with me anymore, if that makes sense. And it was so profound that I was actually weeping, like, in bed, yeah. I know you guys hear my videos and I'm always, but it really is just so, that's a little overstatement, but you know, quite often, there are times. But it's so intense and so loving that it really, that's the only, I mean, anybody who feels it, you pretty well have to do that. It's just such a beautiful feeling. But anyway, so as I'm saying, I'm there with my heart connected to everything and I felt the loss of these two people and it was, I kind of felt their pain, although, you know, being my friend or not, it probably wasn't the end of the world to them, I'm sure. But anyway, I felt it on some level, and I just felt the loss, and I found that very, very profound. Another thing I noticed was that I could feel pain, and I could feel some of the things, you know, that we all have regrets for, like, whatever they are, and I could experience them, but there was the overriding energy of love that made it okay. So I was experiencing them without getting caught up in them. It wasn't bringing me down. It was just almost like I was looking at it as an observer kind of thing, if that makes sense. So it was the love was overriding everything. Now another thing that I noticed, and this is a very important message for me or for anybody, because when you get a connection with Sasquatch, people initially think, well, I'm going in to find out about them and it's about them and stuff. But actually, if you're being taught by Sasquatch, it's always about you, because they are just trying to reintroduce ourselves to our authentic self, you know, which is on that vibration of no judgment, I guess, that's really what it's all about. So as I was going through this experience, laying in bed there, I still had a great love for the Sasquatch, but I wasn't putting them on a pedestal, so to speak, and giving them credit for what was going on. It was like I was taking responsibility for myself and standing in my own light. And that was huge. That was also very huge. Once again, like when you're in this state, it seems like there's an all-knowing too, or there's no need to. It's just everything's complete kind of thing. The other thing was I could feel the love and emotions and things of anybody that I was thinking about. I could feel their heart. And you know, I could put forth compassion for them or empathy or whatever seemed to be needed. It's just I had a really good read on them. You know, another thing that came to my mind too is that when I first started feeling this energy and was getting connected to the energy and Sasquatch were teaching me about energy, because that's really, so much of their lessons are about energy, you know, and the capabilities of it and what it is, and just a really advanced course on energy because of their understanding on it. But early on, Sue and I used to experiment, and we would send energy back and forth to each other, you know, like loving intent. And, you know, quite often we would be able to feel it. And then other times it would come in just from some other source, and we were least expecting it, these love waves, as we described them. And they were dramatic. Sometimes it felt like actually a kick in the stomach if it was so hard. There's some amazing experiences that I had with that, and so. But for the point of this discussion, we were sending energy back and forth, and kind of forgot about that for a while. I haven't been doing that too much. And really, it is important, because your intentions, sending love out to the universe, and your intentions are so very, very important for, you know, for healing. And it's something that I should continue to be doing, and anybody should be doing, I think. And so I was getting a very, very strong feeling that, yes, I've got to start sending that loving energy out.
So anyway,
sending that loving energy out again is something very, very key, and something I'm going to do. And that while I was in that state, it was made very clear to me. Now, something else amazing happened was as I started seeing like almost like a dreams behind my eyes, and then I realized I was kind of seeing what I was thinking. Very strange. And I remember at one time, although I don't really recall thinking this particular thing, I saw a train going through the Rockies, an old locomotive. Then I was thinking about Sasquatch, and I saw a couple Sasquatch faces materialize, and then funny little animals, and stuff like that. And then I started realizing, wait a minute, I'm creating this. It was like what I was thinking, I was starting to see. And it was very, very obvious, but it was also on a, you know, quite a rudimentary level. Well, rudimentary might not be the right word, because it's probably quite evolved into advanced stuff, but it was the beginning of that evolved and advanced kind of thing, I guess, is the way I'm saying it, because the thought I basically had was, wow, I can do this, and it's something I have to work on. So it's something that, you know, can be developed more fully. But in any event, very dramatic when I felt my heart go out and engulf the entire universe, and that universal knowing, connection, love. You know, I've heard many people talk about near-death experiences, and when they were on the other side, they could feel everything. Everybody's thoughts, emotions. And basically, that description is kind of like what I felt. Or basically, right, you know, the hammer on the nail, what I thought. Sounds identical, so that's really amazing. In any event, I wanted to share that with you guys, and love you all. Here I am at my place, and thank you so much for listening. So in any event, I just wanted to talk just a little bit, because I had another thought or two about my experience and how I was creating my dreams and whatever as I thought them. Now, I can't think of the name of the author. But, you know, you can look it up from the name of the book, which is Conversations with God. I'm very much in line with pretty much everything he says, or as much as my knowledge has taken me to, because I've experienced a lot of that. And basically he's saying that when you're on the other side, you can create any reality you want. Lucid dreaming, where you can create your dream. You're participating in it. And that's what this guy who wrote Conversations with God says, except it's much more real. You know, it's more real than this 3D plane or this shell that we inhabit at this time. It's very, very real. And so the interesting thing to me that makes me think is that, you know, I was kind of creating my own realities as I went along. You know, all these things are such big lessons for growth. And so I'm thinking that kind of confirmed, on a very rudimentary scale, like I said, kind of confirmed that, yeah, we can when we get to the other side. And we can actually on this side if we, you know, grow enough or develop that ability enough. But, yeah, that and the fact of the people coming back from near-death experiences and talking about having a knowing and feeling everything, everywhere, like all things, the connection to it, the emotions, the love, the hurt, and yet the hurt being okay because it's in a kind of a blanket of love that kind of lets you see it as an observer instead of you still feel it, but it doesn't drag you down, so to speak. So all those things are really, really amazing. And yeah, a couple really big points that I'm going to say that for me have taken me one more step further in that understanding. And that, of course, is, like I said, creating what I wanted to create. And the knowing and the feeling and the emotions of everything when I was in that state. So, to me, that's a real gift. It's a real gift that I'm very, very grateful for. It's really humbling the way that RE and this clan has taught me, brought me along since 2012. And, you know, my heart and my love is with them. Well, of course, Sue, my girlfriend. I'm not going to get in trouble for not mentioning her, but if that's sincere and heartfelt too. But it's absolutely amazing that the spiritual teachers that they are, and they're here for us, for the individual they're connecting to. And you know, a bonus is you get to know a little bit about them and feel their humor and feel their love and know some of the things they do when they're, you know, in a terrestrial state. And, but really it is all about you. And geez, this last thing that happened, this Love Zap Part 2 or whatever, really for me, tied up some loose pieces and whatever and just furthering me a little further along to an understanding. I just can't even explain how grateful I am. That's beautiful. So thanks for listening.
Inside out.